sure you know what comes in a bag this size and shape. In this video, we're going to find out what makes this wine so unique and who makes it so special. So stay tuned. Hi everyone, and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, I'm so glad you joined us. I'm Carol Chenot, and we post videos weekly for folks that want to know a little bit about a lot of different things. We like to say it helps you connect with your curiosity. And this particular video connects with my curiosity. I'm not a wine drinker. I know, poor me. But I have a lot of friends who are. And I was curious about the process of making wine and the location especially, since we live in an area that has quite a few wineries. So we are today taking a field trip to Center of Effort Winery. And I get to speak with my friend Kathryn Arceneaux, who is not only a sommelier, but works here at the winery. And she has a lot of background to share with us and to give us some insights into what makes this winery so special. So Kathryn.
Hi Carol.
So good to see you.
Good to see you too. Yes. Hey, welcome. Welcome.
Thank you. Well, this is just a gorgeous location.
Yes.
I mean, we've got the fountain, of course, and then it looks like you've prepared something for us here on the lawn.
Oh yes, I definitely did. And so I thought we'd have a little wine tasting today.
Okay.
And kind of see not only what Center of Effort can do, but this is also a beautiful representation of what this little AVA called Edna Valley can do. But let's talk about that. Let's
okay.
go see.
All right.
And this is a really exciting time because we are in the middle of harvest, completing the first week of October. And we have a late start this year. And so of all of Edna Valley. Edna Valley is about 182 miles north of Los Angeles. And what you're viewing, those are the San Luis Mountains, which we are so grateful for, because that is what creates a perfect climate to make Pinot Noir, Chardonnay, and Syrah, and various cool climate wines here. And we're so fortunate because we have like the perfect climate for Pinot Noir, and probably even better than France, but don't let them know because they might get upset about that.
Well, let me back up just a second.
Yeah.
Why is it a late harvest?
Thank you for asking. Mother Nature has her own mind. And here this year in 2021, it has been extremely cool. And we haven't had enough heat to actually ripen the grapes. Mm. So we're going to be harvesting well into November, which isn't that unusual, but it's going to be a very late harvest.
Mm-hmm.
Here we just have 70 acres.
Okay.
And we are completely 100% estate. So that means here we grow it, we harvest it, we make it, bottle, and we serve it here.
Cool. Well, what you've described is just a gorgeous landscape.
Yes.
And winery.
You know, a lot of people ask, where does the name come from? And our owner, Bill Swanson, he is a retired engineer. Center of Effort is an engineer term.
Ah.
And it's also a sailing term.
Okay.
So when you're on a boat, center of effort is when there is equal tension on both sides of the sails. And so this allows the boat to propel smoothly and with harmony. So we'd like to say our wines are in harmony.
Oh, okay. Okay, good.
Yeah.
Good. And so what is your role here at Center of Effort?
So I'm a lead hospitality team member, and I also have my level 3 sommelier. I'm a wine educator.
Hmm.
You know, I educate people not only about our wines, but Edna Valley, as you've learned, and winemaking styles, and anything that our guests really want to know about our particular beautiful wines.
Okay. And so that's part of your life.
Yes.
The other part of your life, as I understand it, is
yeah.
involves a bit more on the food side, right?
Yes.
Tell me about that.
Yeah. So, yes, since 2018, I created my own business out of my passion called Kathryn's Kuisine. I studied basically four European, four Middle East, and four North African countries and their flagship dishes to create my Mediterranean menu. Oh. And I was born and raised in Louisiana, so I have a Cajun menu, so you can't take away my home.
Okay, okay. And I imagine wine is a big part of that.
Yes, and I've created wine and food pairing classes, live and virtual.
Oh, good, good. Wow, so yeah. Congratulations.
Thank you.
So I know our viewers would be very interested in just learning a little bit that they may not know about pairing, like with particular types of dishes, like Mediterranean.
Yes, well, you know, so in front of us, I think these are the, in my humble opinion, the two best wines for food and wine pairing. We have Chardonnay. Chardonnay is a white wine that is so diverse that it can go with pretty much any kind of chicken, fish, light salads, if it is made in the Burgundian style as this is. So Burgundian just simply means it's much higher in acidity, citrus fruit, and with medium body. Pinot Noir, I affectionately call this grape varietal as a white wine in a red dress. I thought you'd like that.
Yes, I do.
Pinot is low in tannins, and so tannins is what makes your mouth dry out, astringent. This is real low. So because of that, this goes so well with almost any type of food. And by the way, this is a great holiday, Thanksgiving and Christmas. You should have these on your table.
Perfect.
Yes.
Perfect. Good. So if someone is unsure, they just can't decide, they're making fancy lasagna, let's say, you know. So what do you do if you just can't decide on the right wine?
Honestly, if you can't decide, you know, tomatoes, you're going to want red. You can't go wrong with Pinot Noir. I mean, we're going to kind of go back to that. My personal choice, believe it or not, would be a Sangiovese or a Chianti, because that is, and so a rule of thumb is what grows there goes together. So that particular part of the world, that's what they make, Chianti and Sangiovese are wines.
Now that's a perfect tip.
And weights and weights, right? Light with lighter wines, heavy with heavier wines.
Yeah.
That's another like easy tip.
Sure, sure. Good. Okay. So the winery, the grounds, the building, everything together is just so inspirational. Tell me what makes it so special in your mind.
You know, what makes it really special is that this is 100% estate, and it's everything is here. We grow it, we make it, and we serve it here. But historically, this was one of the original properties to actually plant grape vines.
Oh.
So this AVA, which stands for American Viticulture Area, is affectionately called Edna Valley, because Edna Valley and this property were the first ones to actually plant grapes here. And so and we have beautiful winemakers who have been here for 11 years. They painstakingly go out in the vineyards. Everything is handcrafted. And I know we use that word so often, but when I tell you everything is touched, it really is, from the barrels that we order, very particular, from the winemaking style, in order to produce these very unique wines that just represent not only Edna Valley, but it's very unique to this particular winery.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah.
That's great. Do you have one that Center of Effort is most known for? One wine?
Oh, well, you know, it's interesting because our Pinots and Chardonnays are pretty well known. We, right now, are the only ones in Edna Valley that's making a Chenin Blanc. So that's very unique. And our highest end Chardonnay is made out of 100% concrete. So I usually have to pause because a lot of people aren't aware of this.
Yeah.
A lot of people know stainless steel vessels. They know, of course, French barrels. But concrete, we actually have these huge concrete egg vessels. They come from France. Mm-hmm. They weigh 1.5 tons. And yes, we don't move them often. And tasting a Chardonnay from those particular eggs, and they stay in there for about 2 years.
Wow.
The concrete still hones in on that fruit, okay. But it really gives it such like a unique mouthfeel. Mm. It's beautiful fruit. There's gonna be citrus, a little bit of pineapple notes, and higher acidity, which actually comes from our land. So our property here is made on a raised sand bed. But why we care is sand actually produces higher acidic wine, and it is that acidity that helps our wines to age longer than our neighboring producers.
Hmm. Well, this has been fascinating, Kathryn. Aww. Hasn't it been fascinating? Yes, it has.
Good. So I'm glad.
Such a wealth of knowledge and information about a topic that is almost everyone's favorite. I mean, there aren't too many folks that don't
food
just
wine.
Appreciate food and wine. So thank you, Kathryn, for what you've shared with us today.
Aww.
Cheers.
Cheers.
For those of you who want to get in touch with Center of Effort, it's centeroffortwine.com, and I will put the link in the description box below. And if you're local, or even if you're not, Kathryn's Kuisine for food and wine, catering, pairing, all of that. She does wonderful virtual celebrations where you could get the whole family together virtually.
Absolutely.
And have a great cooking experience along with some wine. It's always so much fun when we talk to people who have interesting careers. This video shows you a few more. We'll see you in the next video.